Hi. Many of our customers really want to push the boundaries of what's technically possible. Sometimes they want to measure signals that are really tiny. We therefore often hear questions like,
what's the smallest signal I can measure with this device?
Is it possible to measure 5 millibar with your equipment?
Or,
can I measure 1 millinewton with this measuring chain?
Of course, the first thing you should do is pick a sensor that provides the biggest possible output signal. What you want is a sensor with a high sensitivity. On piezoelectric sensors, that means you want as many picocoulomb per physical unit as possible. Let's take the example with 1 millinewton and pick a good force sensor for that. With this sensitivity, 1 millinewton will deliver around 0.1 picocoulomb. Now you need to pick a charge amplifier or a data acquisition system with a charge input to measure the signal. What you usually find in data sheets are the available full-scale ranges. Here, for example, you have different ranges from 1 million picocoulomb down to 100 picocoulomb. The smallest range is 100 picocoulomb on this device. Unfortunately, some people misinterpret this value and think it's the smallest signal they can measure. This is, of course, not true. It is, as the word says, the smallest range. But can I now measure my 0.1 picocoulomb signal with this device? Some users notice that this device is a digital amplifier with a 24-bit AD converter. 24-bit means that the range is basically divided into almost 17 million segments. So 1 bit represents 11.92 attocoulomb. 0.1 picocoulomb should be easy to measure then, right? Well, it's not completely wrong, but it's not that easy. And this approach wouldn't give you any answer if you would use a pure analog amplifier. What matters in the end is the noise floor in the smallest available range of the amplifier. And by noise, I don't mean this kind of noise, but the electric noise of the input stage. Your signal must be bigger than this noise floor to become clearly visible. So compare your expected signal size with the noise level of the amplifier in the smallest range. If we have a look now on the 5167A amplifier, we see that it has a very low noise level of 0.009 picocoulomb RMS. If you're not interested in frequencies above 10 kHz, it's even just 0.007 picocoulomb RMS. With filtering, you can reduce the noise floor even more if your signal has a limited bandwidth. A slow 0.1 picocoulomb signal is clearly visible when the noise floor is 0.007 picocoulomb RMS. Just be aware that an RMS value is an average value. If you want to measure just a quick pulse, you might want to know the noise floor as peak-peak value. Assuming that noise is totally random, you can use factor 6.6 to multiply an RMS value with to approximate the peak-peak value. The theory behind this would fill a separate video. Coming back to the initial questions, there's usually no easy answer, but when you pick the right sensor and you have a look on the noise specification of the amplifier, you get a good idea if it works well or if it might get challenging. Maybe you have to consider another sensor or amplifier, or try if filters can help to increase the signal-to-noise ratio. If you still need help after this video, get in contact with one of our excellent sales engineers out there. See you!